the marine iguana. A truly unique and fascinating lizard, found only on the Galapagos. The Galapagos is an archipelago of volcanic islands in the eastern Pacific, located close to the equator and 500 miles west of Ecuador. The marine iguana is the only lizard on Earth that spends time in the ocean. But what are this remarkable animal's origins? For that, we need to look to mainland Central and South America. Here lives the marine iguana's closest relative, the green iguana. It is theorized that the marine iguana and green iguana both evolved from a common ancestor. The green iguana lives in tropical rainforests, where it feeds on flowers, fruit, and growing shoots. As is the case with other reptiles on the Galapagos, it is believed that millions of years ago, iguanas were carried to the islands from the mainland on rafts of vegetation. The vast majority of such rafts would have sunk well before they ever reached Galapagos. But it would have only taken a handful of successful rafts to wash ashore to enable the iguanas to colonize the islands. Arriving on the Galapagos, these iguanas would have been met with an alien world, void of the jungle habitat that they knew so well. These castaways had the odds stacked against them. Their hunger drove them to search for food in unfamiliar places. At first, they would have foraged in the intertidal zone, on algae exposed during low tide, a practice that is continued to this day. This was enough to sustain a population. As this population grew, the availability of this food source would have been diminished. This would have pushed the iguanas to endure brief periods underwater in the surrounding shallows to access the submerged algae. Eventually, the large adult males started to dive deep beneath the crashing waves. Their brave descendants have perfected this foraging strategy over millions of years. On the sea floor, they can spend several minutes feasting on their primary food source, green and red algae. Before gracefully swimming back to the surface for a breath. Or climbing back onto the cliffs to bask in the sun. While underwater, they swallow a lot of salt water. The salt is filtered from their blood and then excreted by specialized cranial exocrine glands at the nostrils in a process much like sneezing. In the rough waters of the Galapagos Islands, this marine iguana struggles to get back to shore. There's also the added nuisance of the local gang of Galapagos sea lions. To the sea lion, it's nothing more than a game. At last, this marine iguana has made it back to its island home. Marine iguanas live in huge colonies on rocky shores. After mating, the female digs a nest hole in the sand, soil, or volcanic ash, where she lays her eggs before burying them deep to keep them warm. She then abandons the eggs. After a few months, the hatchlings emerge. This marine iguana hatchling had been safe and warm within its egg, buried beneath the sand. It now emerges into a world of monsters. The Galapagos Islands are home to the racer snake. These venomous constrictors wait patiently for the newborns to surface. This marine iguana, just minutes old, has escaped constriction and bolts for the rocks. However, this lizard is not in the clear yet. More racer snakes lie in wait at the rocks. The newborn lizard expertly scales the volcanic rock, while the hungry snakes desperately take strike. The iguana makes it to the relative safety of the summit. And now, for the first time, this iguana can enjoy the epic landscapes of its Galapagos Island home. However, a small proportion of the iguana hatchlings aren't so fortunate. It's marine iguana mating season on the Galapagos Islands. The males become territorial and aggressive. They will threaten each other by bobbing their heads and opening their mouths, displaying the reddish-pink interior. They then approach each other and butt heads, each one attempting to push the other away from the territory and claim its mating rights for himself. During the head-butting, either individual is able to breathe, so they must take breaks between rounds. Eventually, the loser is exiled from the territory. The winner claims the spoils. If you enjoyed this video, then you might like to see how polar bears prey on beluga whales. Also, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to Remarkable Animals, and make sure your notifications bell is turned on. And that way you can stay up to date with all of our latest videos. Thank you for watching.